Welcome to Crewe, located in the northwest of England. Step back in time and discover the soot and sounds of the steam era. Climb aboard iconic living locomotives hungry for coal and water, and work hard on busy passenger and freight services through historic Merseyside and Cheshire. There's an empty poster over there. Let's fix that while we're here. There are more tasks to find. Be sure to refill sand buckets, fill coal sacks, place travel posters, and light braziers. Follow the markers to board the train before departure. Take a seat in first class. You can pause the experience at any point and review previous and current objectives. Check it out now and then return to the game when ready. This train is powered by an LMS Jubilee class steam locomotive. These were built between 1934 and 1936 and originally nicknamed Red Staniers because of their original crimson livery, but later earned the nickname Jubilee when one of their class was named Silver Jubilee in recognition of the Silver Jubilee of King George V. During your journey as a driver on this route, you'll learn to drive this locomotive as well as the LMS Stanier Class 8F, a freight locomotive. You'll learn to haul a variety of different freight between the bustling yards and perform both express and local stopping passenger services. Learn all there is to know about operating these iconic locomotives in an era when steam was king. Welcome to Train Sim World Spirit of Steam, Liverpool to Crewe. Welcome to Runcorn Station. In this training module, we'll be learning how to drive an LMS Stanier Class 8F steam locomotive in BR Black livery. Stand on the platform and wait for your train to arrive. Today, you'll be taking over a freight service bound for Titley. This class of locomotive was built between 1935 and 1946 and was designed as a freight version of the highly successful Black 5 locomotive. Climb up onto the footplate to begin. Let's prepare the locomotive for departure. The reverser determines the direction of travel and also how much power to apply. Move the reverser into the full forward position. This ensures you'll get the maximum power to get the train moving. Use the combination brake to apply both types of brakes simultaneously. Vacuum brakes are released when there is a vacuum in the system. To create a vacuum for the vacuum brakes, we use the ejectors. The small ejector should be left open when the train is running. The large ejector can be used to more quickly increase the vacuum after coupling or heavy braking. Open the cylinder cocks to remove any water from cylinders after it has been left standing. Water in the cylinders can damage the locomotive if it doesn't compress like steam. The regulator acts like the throttle for the steam locomotive. It controls how much steam is delivered to the cylinders. Slowly open the regulator to apply power. Remember that power delivery is delayed in a steam locomotive. Applying too much power too early. Now we're moving, we can open the regulator some more. Starting to pick up speed, move the reverser towards the mid-gear. This reduces the amount of steam let into the cylinder, but saves energy. Approaching the next stop, let's prepare the train for stop. Close the regulator. Bring the train to a stop in the indicated position. Great work. Let's see how you did. Welcome to Allerton. In this introduction, we'll be learning how to drive an LMS Jubilee class steam locomotive in BR Green livery. This class of locomotive was built between 1934 and 1936 and nicknamed Jubilee after one of its class was named Silver Jubilee. To get started, climb onto the footplate. Take a seat in the driver's position. This is where you'll be spending most of your time. In this lesson, we will be performing passenger operation. We're now ready to depart for West Allerton. The reverser determines the direction of travel and also how much power to apply. Move the reverser into the full forward position. This ensures you'll get the maximum power to get the train moving. As you pick up speed, you'll need to move it towards the centre to save power. Slowly open the regulator to apply power. Remember that power delivery is delayed in a steam locomotive. To create a vacuum for the vacuum boat, we use the ejectors. Starting to pick up speed, move the reverser towards the mid-gear. This reduces the amount of steam let into the cylinder, but saves energy. Approaching the next station, let's prepare the train to slow down. Use the combination brake to apply both types of brakes simultaneously. we can now continue the journey to Mossley Hill. To create a vacuum for the vacuum brakes, we use the ejectors. Now close the doors and prepare to depart for Edge Hill unguided. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train. Welcome to Ditton Junction. In this training module, we will learn how to read and react to semaphore signalling. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Green indicates that you are clear to pass the signal. Yellow indicates that you can proceed, but with caution, as the next signal might be red or there could be a hazard. Red indicates that you should stop and should not pass this signal. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. Now let's take a look at some of the signals you'll see on this line. There are two principal classes of signals. Home and starter signals. These are mandatory and an approaching driver must stop if the signal displays a danger aspect. Distant signals. These are a warning. An approaching driver may pass the signal displaying a caution aspect, but must be prepared to stop at the following signal. The signal in front of you is currently displaying a danger aspect. That means the line ahead is not clear and you must wait. The signal in front of you has now cleared. However, the next distant signal could display caution, meaning that the following signal will be displaying a danger aspect. Stay vigilant and keep an eye out for the next signal. Proceed when ready. Just look at the heads-up display if you're unsure what the next signal is. Great work. That's everything for this training module. Welcome to Speak Sidings. In this training module, we will learn how to refill the tender with water before coupling up to a set of freight wagons. Firstly, we'll need to prepare the locomotive to receive water. Walk over to the water crane where you will need to move the water hose over the rear of the locomotive's tender. Now the hose is in position, climb up the tender and open the water hatch. Insert the hose into the tender tank once the water hatch is open. The hose is in and the tender tank is ready to be filled. Turn on the water and start filling the tender tank. The tender tank is now full. Turn off the water and bring the hose back to the water frame before closing the water. Now we need to fill the tender with coal. Yeah. The locomotive is ready to go, but the points in front need switching. These points are manually controlled, so we'll have to leave the locomotive and walk to the points. Pull the junction lever to switch the direction of the points. The locomotive is now ready to move. Climb aboard the locomotive and drive it to the stop marker. Points into the siding have been set for us. Slowly reverse into the sidings and stop in front of the wagons. The couple to the wagons climb down from the locomotive and walk to the rear of the tender. The wagons are now coupled and the service is ready to start. Climb back aboard the locomotive and drive to the yard exit to finish this training module. Great work. That's everything for this training module.